Absolutely. And Yair, how do we, how does Israel benefit from this particular relationship with the UAE, not just the Arab world, not just because it's part of the Arab world, but between Israel and the UAE, what are the direct benefits for either side of the parties here?
So there are huge benefits for Israel and for the UAE, by the way. So the UAE is basically the first adopter of technologies in the Arab world. It's the most Western country there. Huge millennial generation adoption of smartphones and internet are the highest in the world. E-commerce is growing significantly. You know, Uber just purchased a company called Careem in January for $3 billion. They have Souq acquired by Amazon, Noon, which is a huge e-commerce company. So I think now that Israeli companies, as Ariel mentioned, can actually come in the market and get more involved and compete and join forces and cooperate, it's a huge achievement and great could be a great success story. I would also add that what you may see now, and I've been involved in that in the last 2 years or so, you are going to see venture capital coming from the UAE to Israeli companies directly and to the Israeli funds.
In what industry are we going to be seeing this most likely?
So, you know, people like to talk a lot about the agro-technology and water treatment and all those areas. I'm frankly more interested in the core businesses of the Israeli tech, right, which is cybersecurity, e-commerce, anti-fraud, digital health, et cetera, management, tool management, et cetera, anything that is online, right? And that's what's happening now in the UAE, and I think that Israeli companies moving there are going to see great success.
Okay, now Ariel, you touched on something earlier, but I wanted to head back to, and that's the issue of the Palestinians. Now, let's take a listen to the Minister of State for Foreign Affairs from the UAE before we discuss.
So we were thinking, let us try and put one and one together. Let us try and develop this organic relationship that is developing with Israel in many, many areas. And let's really try and get something tangible. And the idea was very clear that Israel will commit in a three-way phone call with the United States to stopping annexation, suspending it, and at the same time, we will be able to also announce that we will begin what I would call a normal relationship with Israel in various areas. Technology, investment, healthcare, agriculture, etc.
Right. So, Ariel, we just heard mentions there of the annexation issue. How have the Palestinians reacted, and have the UAE saved the Palestinians from annexation?
Yeah. Well, as I mentioned, it's considered a betrayal. Benjamin Netanyahu didn't really want to go ahead with the annexation. The Trump administration put their foot on the ground and said no, and so did the international community. It was a very convenient way for Netanyahu to climb down the tree that he found himself on, saying to the Israeli people, here, we didn't annex the West Bank or the Jordan Valley, but I brought something in return, and there's a good cause. I want to mention something about the interest and the geopolitical interest in the area, besides what Yair mentioned regarding M&As and acquisitions and activities in fields like cyber, like telecommunications, et cetera, that are very strong with Israeli tech. Beyond that, there is the issue of oil. Israel is very much a reliant in terms of oil from the Gulf on Kurdish Iraqi oil that it gets from Turkey, a third party, which is very unstable in the last few years with the relationships between Israel and Turkey deteriorating. Now it has a partner that has 6% of the world's reserves of oil, which is going to be a very, very good client for the UAE, Israel, and of course a very good customer for the UAE as well. Beyond that, they have the mutual interest of stopping the radicalization in Iran.
On that point, security, I was going to ask Yair as well. There seems to be, there's always been these relationships, as we said, mentioning through high tech and things like that, but we see a lot of limitations when it comes to defense as well. Are we likely to see anything there, or is this still a very sensitive industry?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, so what's the interest of the UAE in Israeli defense, right? It is where they cannot acquire technologies from other countries, or that we have something that others do not, typically perhaps only the US, right? The question then is, how do the Israeli authorities look at providing the right permits, what technologies, military technologies, they are now going to allow. And I do expect that as the relationship gets closer, that we'll see more permits for more advanced technologies being shipped there.
Absolutely. Okay, Ariel, Yair, thank you both so much for joining us. But we do have to go.